Git is the most popular version control system. Git commands are executed from the command line. Using the command line is quite easy, but some operations are more convenient to perform using a graphical interface. In this video, I'm going to show how to use Git with Visual Studio. My name is Pat. If you are new here, consider subscribing because it motivates me to make more videos. Let's get into it. I will be using Visual Studio 2022 on a Windows machine. Things may look a bit different if you use a prior version of Visual Studio or if you use Visual Studio for Mac. I'm going to create a WPF application whose purpose is to upload files to Azure Blob Storage. Along the way, I will show you some Git concepts. First thing first, let's create the project. The newly created application is not yet tracked by Git. If I want to initialize a new Git repository, I go to the menu and select Git, then create Git repository. In the dialog window, I select local only, then I click on the create button. You can see in the status bar a notification saying that the repo has been created successfully. Still in the status bar, you can see that new buttons have appeared. The button with the project name shows all the local repositories. This button next to it allows displaying all the branches. At the moment, I only have the master branch. The button with the pencil and the counter show the change that is not committed yet. This button next to it displays the number of commits that need to be pushed or pulled from the remote repository. Most of these operations can also be performed from the Git menu. Most of the time, you will work on a branch and merge changes from your branch back to the master branch. To create a branch, I go to the Git menu, I select New Branch. In the dialog box, I set the name of the new branch. The drop-down lists all the branches, so you can choose which one to base your branch on. Because I only have the master branch, it's already selected. The checkbox Checkout Branch allows switching to the new branch after it's created. I click on the Create Branch to create the branch. You can see in the status bar the name of the branch. If I click on it, the names of all branches are displayed. I can switch from one branch to another branch from here. I'm going to make some changes to the user interface of my application. In the status bar, you can see next to the button with a pencil, a counter shows the number 2. If I click on it, it opens the Git changes window. As the name implies, this window shows the changes in the repository. Indeed, I have 2 changes, one on the main window.xaml and the other on its code behind file. Double clicking on the file in the changes section shows the changes made to the file. In this case, you can see that I added new controls to the XAML file. In the code behind, you can see that I added a new event handler to handle clicking on the button. In the changes section, you can click on the plus button to add the changes to the staging area. You can see that they appear in the stage changes. Changes in the staging area are ready for the next commit. At this point, I need a commit message and click on the commit stage button. There is another way to commit changes. I remove the file from the staging area by clicking on the minus button. You can see that the commit button displays commit all now. I can commit the changes without going through the staging area. A commit message is mandatory. I click on the commit all button to commit changes. Notice that the changes counter is now at 0. If I click on the commit link, I can see all the changes in the commit. If I want to see all the commits, I can go to the Git menu and select View Branch History. Off camera, I did introduce three changes. If I go to the Git menu and select View Branch History, you can see the three commits. If I click on the first of the three, you can see the change. I introduced a service for uploading files to Azure Blob Storage. In the second commit, I introduced a method that allows the user to select files from a dialog. In the last commit, I used a service to upload files selected by the user. Instead of having three commits in the branch history, I may want to combine these commits into a single one. To do that, I select the commits I want to combine. I right-click on the selection. In the menu, I select Squash Commits. The dialog displays the three commits message. I need to replace them with a new commit message. I click on the squash button to merge the commits into a single one. If I click on the new commit in the history, I can see the three changes. Let's say I want to change the size of the main window. I update the width, and for some reason, I also update the background. I commit the change. I realized that changing the background color was a mistake. I remove the background property. If I commit the change with a message like removing background property, it has no value and will pollute the history of the branch. Instead, I want to override the last commit. To do that, I put the same commit message, change main window size. Next to the commit button, I select the amend checkbox. If I commit the change and refresh the branch history, you can see that the number of commits is the same. But if I show the details of the last commit, you can see that the background property is gone and the width is updated. Commit amend allows modifying the last commit. At this point, I have a working program. I want to save my code in the cloud. GitHub is the most popular cloud hosting service for code. I already have an account. I go to the Git menu. I select Push to Git Service. Because I have already pushed code to GitHub before, Visual Studio has saved my credential. I add a description for the remote repository. I click on the Push button. I got a notification in the status bar stating that the repository was created successfully. If I go to my GitHub repository, I can see the new repo. Let's pretend that the remote repository has changed. For instance, a README file has been introduced. How do I know that the remote repository contains changes? In the Git Changes window, I click on the first button, which is the fetch command. Once the command is executed, you can see that this indicator has been updated. It shows that we have one commit we can pull from the remote repository. Zero outgoing indicated that we have nothing to push to the remote repository. If I click on the pull button, the changes have been committed in my local branch. I can go to the root of the solution directory. The README file is there. Now I made a small change in the project. I remove unused namespaces. I commit the change. The indicator shows that there is one commit that can be pushed to the remote repository. Before pushing local commits, it's good practice to pull any commits on the remote repo first. If I click on the Fetch button, you can see that the indicator has been updated. It indicates that someone made changes to the remote repo. I can pull the remote changes and then push local changes in one command. For that, I click on the Sync button. You can see that I have zero outgoing and zero incoming. Now let's say the work on the branch is done. I want to merge the changes into my master branch. From the Git menu, I select Manage Branches, which displays all the branches. I switch back to the master branch. Now I right-click on the branch I was working on, which is named Upload Files, and select Merge Upload Files into Master. The merge is complete. You can see in the history that changes have been integrated. Alternatively, I could also rebase the Upload Files branch into the master branch. Rebase command is a more advanced feature that you should use carefully. Once I have merged the branch, I no longer need it. I can delete it. I am working on a new branch named Add Configuration File. I receive a bug saying that the width of the window is incorrect. How can I fix the bug in the master branch while working on another branch? I fix the bug in the Add Configuration File branch. Then I switch to the master branch. I right-click on the commit that fixed the bug, and I select Cherry Pick. Now you can see the commit in the history of the master branch. If I look into the file, I can see that the fix has been applied. Cherry Pick allows you to select a commit from one branch and apply it to another. Let's say I want to remove changes from a particular commit. I have a commit with the message paint main button in red. How can I remove changes related to this commit? From the branch history, I right-click on the commit and I select revert. If I refresh the history, you can see that the new commit has been created. Revert paint button in red. In the commit details, you can see that the changes have been reverted. Revert allows undoing the changes introduced by a commit. What if I want to revert many changes from many commits? In the history shown on the screen, I want to cancel the last three commits. I can right-click on the commit I want to go back on. I select Reset. I have two options: Keep Changes and Delete Changes. Delete Changes will remove any stage changes, while Keep Changes will keep stage changes. I select Delete Changes. If I refresh the history, you can see that the last three commits have been removed. Reset allows resetting a branch to a previous state. When merging changes, conflicts can appear. How do I resolve them? I have made changes to a branch called Fix Bug No File Selected. Now I want to merge the changes into the master branch. I switch back to the master branch. I right-click on the branch, Fix Bug No File Selected. I receive a warning message: Merge completed with conflict in the Git demo. If I click on the Resolve the Conflict link, it shows me the file that result in conflict in the Git changes window. If I click on the file, I can compare the changes from both branches. I select the change in the Fix Bug No File Selected branch as the winner. Then I click on Accept Merge. I need to complete the merge with a commit message, and I commit the changes. This tutorial ends here. You have seen how to use Visual Studio to perform Git operations you need on a daily basis. If you find this video helpful, give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.